Circuit Court of the Ninth Judicial Circuit in Fort Orange County, Florida is now open. The Honorable Baldwin Perry Jr., Chief Judge presiding.
You may be seated. Okay. Madam Clerk, you may call the case.
2008 CF 15606-0, State of Florida versus Casey Moran.
Okay, let the record reflect that the defendant is present along with counsel for the defendant, Assistant State Attorney. We're here on the motion filed by the defense, motion clarifying motion for leave to file additional witnesses. Mr. Mason, you may proceed, sir.
The good news is that for the most part, I'm advised the state doesn't have objections, so we don't have to spend a lot of time here to some part of it. One of the witnesses we listed, a CADU, a C-A-D-I-E-U-X, we're voluntarily striking. Not either side been able to get cooperation for deposing her. All of the rest of the witnesses have been deposed by the state, with the exception of Drs. Danziger and Weitz, who are scheduled for deposition next week.
Okay. State?
Your Honor, there were two separate motions for leave to file additional witnesses. One did contain Dr. Danziger and the other Dr. Weitz. Mr. Ashton will address that in a moment. The remainder dealt with witnesses affiliated with searches off of Suburban Drive, either as representatives of Texas Search or individuals who went on their own. The court had ordered Mr. Mason to provide those names before the end of December of last year. He had done that in a letter to me. This is his formal filing of most of those witnesses. They have been deposed. Today was my deadline to depose them, except for the individual that Mr. Mason has indicated is being voluntarily withdrawn. Therefore, we would not be in a position to argue any prejudice for their filing at this time.
Okay. Mr. Ashton?
Sir, as to Dr. Danziger, Dr. Weitz, the counsel is correct. We have them set for deposition next week. Until that deposition is done, we really have no information to give the court about whether there's good cause for late disclosure or whether there's prejudice. So what I would suggest to the court is for those witnesses that the court simply reset the matter to a time after the depositions are done, and then we can let you know whether, you know, there is good cause or not, and whether there's any prejudice to the state or not, or where we go from there. We did receive reports from the witnesses, but they're rather limited and not.
I take it those were the reports that I also got, the two letters.
I wasn't aware that you had received the reports.
That's
fine. I mean, if you have, that's fine. I wasn't.
So we can all be on the same page. Y'all can come up here and look and see what I received.
Yes, these appear to be the same ones that I was emailed.
Okay, I was emailed those also. My home away from home.
Yes, sir. So once we've explored more fully, you know, the various issues about, you know, when this was pursued, et cetera, and what the possible prejudice is,
okay, when are the depositions next week?
7th. They're both set for April 7th.
Okay. Just a second. So that's next Thursday?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right.
We actually have a status conference. My calendar says set for Friday the 8th.
Right.
So we could just address it then if you like.
Okay. There is one matter, if the attorneys approach the bench, that I need to alert you to about the 8th. Okay, I think that takes care of everything we needed to take care of.
One thing I did want to announce, the court in one of its prior orders had indicated that the party should exchange, or that we should provide the defense with photographs we're going to use at trial. I have prepared a CD. I had intended to bring it this morning and walked out without it. I have one for the court, I have one for counsel, and a notice of filing. It's 236 photographs, so I should be delivering those today for you to look at, and we can address any objections.
What I want to do is the week of the 18th and the week of the 25th, all housekeeping matters, going over the photographs and the objections and all the things we need to wrap up that we can get wrapped up, any final motions that may pop up as a result of anything. We can do it sooner than that, but those are the 2 weeks that I'm reserving. I don't plan on traveling to Tallahassee.
I just got a notice of jury to be one of those weeks. I assume you'll be able to get me out of it.
I think I may have a little sway with that.
Just for everyone's, the CDs do contain photographs that have been previously sealed by prior court order because they contain the remains, so just so that everyone knows they do contain that. But you should get those today and be able to go through them.
Okay.
So we'll see you tomorrow, I guess.
Okay. How many more? I received notification from my JA that y'all had withdrawn, not withdrawn, but you want me to rule on the pleadings on the motion on spoliation.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Oh, I wasn't aware that was your request. I thought that was the court's. Yes. But that's fine.
Okay. So what we have left for tomorrow?
One thing I do want to, there are two spoliation motions, one of which I've responded to, and the later filed one in reference to the garbage, I don't believe I have responded to, if I'm recalling correctly. So I wasn't aware that the defense had asked me to file it on the pleadings. I just got it. I assume that was from the judges, but not. Oh, okay. That's interesting. So that's the question. Which motion are we talking about?
The one you responded to,
okay,
and the other one I think is going to be merged into effectively with the argument regarding Dr. Boss. We can finish that tomorrow.
Okay. Yeah, y'all have some witnesses on Dr. Voss, and I'm trying to remember without.
We really have the only testimony I guess we finished was the hair motion. All the other motions, I think the testimony, if I recall correctly, the defense still wanted the testimony on a number of different motions. So, but if we don't, at least we don't have any testimony on this spoliation motion.
All I'm trying to do is get an idea whether or not I need to tell staff to be prepared to work on Saturday.
Well, I was in California, so I don't know. I tried to watch this from 33,000 feet, and it was very jerky. It worked out so good. But I do
know, kind of jerky here, too.
Well, think about yourself. The fact of the matter is that I believe Mr. Baez is calling two witnesses and then arguing. I think that's all there is. I see no reason why you'd be going into Saturday for any purpose.
Fantastic. All right. Very good.
I don't know. I'm just telling you that if necessary, we will be here Saturday morning. And if necessary, Sunday.
We're starting at 9.
When, tomorrow?
Tomorrow.
I thought I had said 8:30, but if y'all, I had said 8:30. Now, if y'all think y'all will finish, we'll start at 9. But
seems like we will, but whatever you want.
You tell me.
I think
I already told you all I'd tell
you. Yeah.
Card?
I told you all I'd tell you. There's two witnesses. An argument, and I see no reason.
You want to start at 8:30 or 9 o'clock? It makes me no difference. Unfortunately,
I vote
whether
for nine.
I want to or not, I wake up at 5:30.
We vote for 9.
In which case, I'll say 8:30. No.
9
o'clock is fine.
Okay. 9 a.m. tomorrow morning.
Thank you.
All right, thank you.